Sometimes part of eating disorder recovery means dealing with weight gain, and that could be something extremely difficult for someone struggling. So I'm going to give you five tips on how to deal with that today. First, welcome to my channel. Welcome back to my channel. My name is Stephanie. I'm Long Island's eating disorder specialist. I post on this channel twice a week, all about eating disorders, body image issues, and general mental health. So if any of that is interesting to you, please click the subscribe button down below. And I would love it if you considered subscribing to my email list using the link in the description below. What you'll get there are newsletters each week at the beginning of the week, letting you know what content I have coming forward for you. And I create resources to go along with many of my videos. So if there's any corresponding resources to the videos coming out that week, you will get it in those newsletters. This actually was a requested video from one of my followers on Instagram, and I believe here as well. But I also want to just put forth that if you are ever wanting to me to talk about something, if you want my opinions about something as an eating disorder therapist, whatever the case might be, feel free to either leave it in the comments or DM me over on Instagram. And I would love to hear what those things are so that I can produce content that's more tailored to what you are looking for. Without further ado, I'm going to go over five things that could be helpful for you when it comes to dealing with weight gain in recovery. So the number one thing I want to talk about is releasing body expectations. I know that this is really difficult to do because a lot of times, especially when it comes to eating disorders or just being in our culture in general, we have developed expectations for how a person should look, how we should look, and we are very, very critical of ourselves with that, especially as it pertains to our body, our body's shape, our body's toneness, our body's everything. We have expectations, and it's really, really important. I know it's difficult to do, but to try to recognize what those expectations are and to let go of them. And letting go is a whole process, and it's very difficult. It's not to say that it's something that is an easy thing to do, but it is first recognizing the expectations that you have and then working on making conscious efforts to try to let them go. And I talked about this on an IGTV video recently about how to let go. So if you'd like that, go ahead over there and I could talk more and about how to actually apply this tool of letting go. A lot of times the expectations that we have of our body is simply are just not attainable, unless sometimes they are, but it would really take a lot of basically just all you could do is focus on that, and it's a lot of times usually resulting from very not so healthy behaviors. Sometimes what we need to do is just recognize that the expectations that we have on our bodies are just not going to happen, and that is okay. My second tip is having compassion toward yourself, as well as learning how to self-soothe. It's really important that we recognize that when we have body expectations, as I talked about in the last tip, it can be really, really harsh on us. We could be judgmental, we could be overly critical, and that's not helpful, and that's not going to help you deal with the weight gain that may happen in recovery. What we need to do is recognize what we're doing to ourselves and to start having self-soothing, compassionate statements to ourselves. So what that may look like is if you constantly are saying that you're just so fat, no one could ever love you. Well, say, and I know this might be really, really difficult for you, but saying stuff like, well, I love me. And maybe you might not believe it right now, and that's okay. But trying to bring yourself into saying things like that. Or if you are not at that point, what about recognizing that there are people around you that love you? How about your mom? Does your mom love you? And trying to really separate the unhealthy part of you, because maybe the unhealthy part is saying she doesn't. But when you can recognize the healthy part is saying, yeah, I know my mom loves me. So while my mom loves me, I'm my mother's child, why can't I love me? It doesn't matter. She doesn't love me because of the way my body is shaped. I don't love her because of the way that her body is shaped. And having some compassionate statements to yourself. And it's really important to even talk in a voice that is much more soothing. Like I always normally do when I'm talking on this channel or on IGTV or wherever I'm talking, and I'm trying to really express, or when I'm talking to my clients, compassion, my voice changes and the pitch changes, and it's just much more comforting. So recognize how you would talk maybe to a child and easing them and comforting them, And talk that way to yourself. Soothe yourself and use compassionate statements toward yourself. Maybe even saying stuff like, you don't have to be perfect. You don't have to go into the same shape as what society seems to be telling you. You don't have to. There's alternatives for your body than the expectations that you have set for yourself. And it's beautiful. I know that's hard. And I know that you might not believe all of that. But it's okay. Compassion and self-soothing is necessary. 3 is coping. Finding ways to cope. Finding when you have struggles with dealing with the weight gain, a lot of times when you have eating events, such as meals or snacks, that may be when you notice anxiety increasing when it comes to your weight and your eating disorder and recovery. So if that's the time that you tend to notice a spike in anxiety, how can you learn to cope with that? How can you be proactive with it and have proactive coping mechanisms in place? And how can you be reactive about it? So next time it does come up, how can you react in positive, constructive, adaptive, healthy coping ways that can help you be in your recovery and dealing with that weight gain? 4 is body neutrality. And this is something that is much more attainable than body positivity for a lot of people. Not to say that you should never try to get to the place of being body positive, but a lot of people seem to forget this step, that it might be not something in the cards for you right now to be totally like digging your body, and that's okay. But how can we get to a point of being neutral? You probably already have a lot of self-hating statements about your body. How can we replace them with neutral statements? So a negative statement or a self-hatred type of statement would be, my body's so ugly. But a neutral statement really would just be reporting the facts, being objective about it. So you can look at your body being like, well, I have 2 arms and 2 legs. And that's a statement about your body that is neither negative nor positive. And if anything, it should be a positive, but it's just stating the facts. If you think that your eyes are ugly, you could say, okay, well, I have gray eyes. If you think that your hair is just like ratty, well, why not just report on the length of your hair? My hair's length is past my shoulders, whatever. I know these may seem like random statements and they may feel really odd to be reporting on or to say, but what we have now are very, very unnecessary and unhealthy statements about your body. So why not? What do you have to lose by just reporting on what is objective, what anyone can see, and that's not with a bias to it? Because at this point in time, your bias seems to be negative, and it's going to be a negative thing for you to use the statements that have bias in it. If I were able to say that you have a positive bias, then I would recommend doing that instead. But if that's not the case, which most likely isn't if you're in this video, let's work on neutral statements, neutralizing the statements that you're saying about your body, moving the statements that you say about your body, yourself, whatever, from hatred or negativity to neutrality. Lastly, what I want to talk about here, my 5th tip, is body acceptance. I know this is really difficult. This is something that kind of goes along with the other things that I said, that it's really important to be able to learn how to accept your body as is. And it's important to recognize that body acceptance is not body complacency. When you accept your body, it is extremely freeing. It does not mean that there's nothing that you want to change, or that if you had a magic wand and could change something that you could and that you would. That's okay to have things that you wish may have been a little different. But when it's not okay is when it hurts you to such an extent that it interrupts your life and it causes you to engage in unhealthy or negative maladaptive coping or just behaviors overall. So when you are able to say, okay, my body isn't necessarily what I wanted. My body isn't necessarily how I expected it to be. However, my body is functioning for me right now. It's doing what it needs to be doing. It is working for me. And you know what? At the very least, all I could do is accept it. That at this point in time, I'm not going to work against you anymore. I'm going to say, huh, you know what? I can accept this. And it's not something that is going to have such a hold on you anymore. Another part of this is accepting that your body is in a transition mode right now. and your body has not really caught up to where it's supposed to be. Your body is kind of in a chaotic state at this moment in time. If you've engaged in eating disorder behaviors for a while, your body is getting used to not having that anymore. And it's gonna take some time. It might not be a pleasant experience. It likely won't be a pleasant experience. You might have increases in weight that may be temporary, it may not be. But oftentimes you will see a lot of changes occurring within your body that's not necessarily permanent, but it's a matter of really trying to work through that, use your coping skills to be able to get through that, and allow your body time. Allow your body time to adjust and get to the point that it needs to be at, and allow your body the justice to be able to do the things that you need to be doing in recovery, and just be patient with it. Be patient with your body, allow it time to adjust, have compassion toward your body, have recognition that you put it through a lot, and start having compassion toward that, just as though you would with another person. If you put someone through a lot of crap, wouldn't you have some compassion when you realize what you've done? Wouldn't you say, listen, I'm sorry, let me do something to help you? Let's do that for your body. Let's make amends. Let's say, listen, my body, I am sorry for all the crap that I put you through. I'm sorry for the abuse that I put you through. And I recognize that right now, this is just you trying to get to the point so that you can best sustain me. I'm going to do my best to accept you and to be patient with you. I hope you found this video helpful. If you did, please give it a thumbs up. Leave a comment down below if you have any tips for really dealing with weight gain and recovery. You could click my face over here to subscribe to my channel, and I wish you body acceptance on your journey to finding your state of balance, and I will see you in my next video.